You can never whip these boys if you don't keep you and them separate. I found that out in Birmingham. You've got to keep the white and the black separate.
Yes, this might be any city of the Deep South going about its daily business. But there is something different about it now, especially here in the heart of the city. What's different? The buses are empty. Why? Because the Negro people aren't riding them. Because one woman, a seamstress, tired after a hard day's work, got fed up with her 40 years of living under Jim Crow. Because one woman said, I have had enough. And suddenly, just like that, 50,000 voices answered, Amen, sister, enough for us too. For refusing to give up her seat to a white man, she was arrested and fined. And the Negro people of Montgomery have refused to ride the buses ever since. They walked instead. They rode in cars, their own cars, instead of anyone who would give them a lift. The buses waited still and lonely in their silent rows, or rode empty through the streets. They were threatened and intimidated, arrested, convicted and fined, and still they walked. In the rain and the sun and the dark of night, they walked with God and shunned the buses. They walked with God and they rode with God too, for they formed a carpool that was a marvel of quick organization. It started as a one-day protest, nothing more. But it grew until it rocked the cradle of the Confederacy and told the world a story of Negro people united for action without bitterness, without malice, without fear.
There's one thing I can say, that all of when the buses were finally put out of business and the bus drivers were out of work, they were employed as policemen. So they had a continuation of income. And many of those policemen would give just hundreds and hundreds of tickets every day to people who were not violating any traffic laws, but they were doing it to help to raise the salaries that they had lost.